chill. I don't know. I want to do work at work. I'm telling you.
Yo, you heard it here. If you're working at work, you're doing it wrong. Yeah.
Cheers.
Cheers. For real. Get an espresso, guys. Mm-hmm. I'm going to talk about this every week until I get one myself.
And you got the mini Keurig, right?
Yeah, I got the mini. Oh, it is trash.
How much was it?
It was like $65 with tax. Like, it's something to hold me down.
Yeah, yeah.
So, something to hold me down.
Because you were saying you were buying a coffee every
day. I was buying a coffee every day, two or three. So that's like at least $5. Yeah.
How close is like Tim Hortons or McDonald's near you?
Oh, it's not far. Maybe like less than a 10-minute walk.
Okay.
Like, it's not too bad.
Okay,
yeah,
that's all right.
But it was just the fact of like I wanted a coffee. I didn't have one at home, you know? So $5 and I waited like 2 weeks. So right there, that's money.
Yeah.
Money gone. So
money could have been put into
to the Keurig. Nespresso. Yeah. You're right. So I got the single serve and you literally have to refill it every single time. And it takes 2 minutes to brew.
The water?
Yeah, it's like a small little Keurig.
It's just a cup.
Yeah. So, yeah. Whatever.
I mean, at least you got something.
I got something, homie. I can't complain. Yep. This is first world problems. Like,
yeah.
First world problems.
It's all perfect. Like, it's probably perfect for that.
If you only want person.
Mm.
Yeah, exactly.
That is true.
But,
fuck, man. This is a big thing. I heard this today, actually, when I was walking my dog. But I wanted to mention, what's one thing you heard as a kid that sounds dumb as fuck right now? Like, just thinking back, you're just like, what the fuck? I live by a school, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Like, a school is right in front of my house. So, mm-hmm. when I walk out, I see the kids play. You know?
Yeah. Shut the fuck up.
Yeah. And this one kid, I was this kid. This one kid went on the snowbank.
Okay.
And the teacher's like, don't go on the snowbank without your snow pants. What? But when I walk home, I can trench through the snow.
No problem.
No problem.
No problem.
It would make me so mad.
They, in whatever weird way, are covering their own ass.
Yeah, 100%. That's, I will say that's probably a liability thing.
Yeah.
But, like, just because you got snow pants, you can now go on the hill? Like, what?
That's the groundbreaking discovery of snow pants.
Yeah. And it's not like my pants under can't get wet at all.
What are they worried that, like, it is, like, frostbite? It must, like,
You get sick
or, like, track it inside. With your... No, because you got to wear the snow pants inside and take it... I don't know.
It
just put me over the edge. I almost walked over and be like, look, listen, teacher. Listen, teach.
Please just let him play. Don't do that to him.
It just brought back memories because...
Yeah, triggered.
I got that all the time. And I was like, bro, I'm not bringing snow pants to school.
I don't know what's really... What I've heard,
yeah,
that has made me like.
I know it's kind of like a random thing.
That's a hard,
like,
one.
I don't. You don't have anything that's like kind of like what the fuck, like.
Like, why would they say that?
Yeah, why would they say that?
It's definitely got to be. Oh, okay. Actually, you know what? I might as well follow this up.
Okay.
I understand that when you had teachers, you would call them Mr. or Mrs.
Yeah.
Okay, mm-hmm. I understand that. It's a sign of respect.
Yeah.
But why in the world did they get so goddamn angry if you just mentioned their first name?
For real.
See, I was always like Mrs. and then I would say their first name.
Oh, really?
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 They wouldn't mind that.
I would only call a teacher by their first name if they really liked me and we were close, which I could end up doing with a couple of teachers.
I don't know.
Like Gibbs, like, hey, yo, Mr. Gibbs.
Yeah.
Like, I'd always say Mr., and then I'd say it every time.
Or what was our history teacher?
Oh,
Her first name was Linda, I believe.
History?
Yeah. What? I don't know. I can't remember. Anyways, I could be completely wrong, but I would call her by her first name, and she didn't give a shit.
Really?
She's like, what's up?
I can picture her, but I don't
think... Glasses. Remember her?
Yeah, because she...
Older woman. She accused you?
Yeah.
No way.
Because I didn't cite my stuff.
No way.
I showed it after, and then she's like, oh.
Oh, okay.
She like pulled me out of the room.
Like, go, shut up.
She copied this shit. I'm like, no.
Well,
I was like, well, yeah, they're links. They're like, you know, you had to show like evidence.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Where you
so, like,
got it.
Links to the websites. And then she finally clued in because I didn't like link properly.
Yeah, whatever. Anyways.
Bro, I will say teachers just piss me off.
So this is what I'm saying. Like,
in general.
In my opinion, I don't think it is the worst thing to call a teacher by their first name.
Yeah.
I really don't think it is. But some of these teachers be acting, excuse me?
Yeah, they get pissed.
What's my name? Yeah. And you keep saying their first name. Like, what? Huh? What did you say? Yeah, like, chill the fuck out.
Yeah, that's kind of...
Unless, look, if you are a teacher and there is a strict reason, tell me. Because I don't know what it is.
100%.
But just by first glance and having the experience of going to school, I don't get that.
Yeah. I think it's more or less just like a formal thing. But
yeah, for sure.
But you're right, getting so mad that it's like... You're like, yo. Especially, I get elementary school.
Yeah, that's different.
That's 100% different. You want to, like, you know...
You're teaching.
Yeah. But once I'm in high school, like, the fuck?
You're preparing me for college. Like, yeah.
I want to know your name. Like, I'm going to call you by your name.
I can understand if, like, if, okay, you're the student, I'm the teacher. Say, hey, Tyrell.
Hey, Tyrell.
Excuse me? What's my name?
I just wanted to know about
the No. What's my name?
Tyrell.
What's my name?
Mr. Tyrell.
I can't hear you. I can't hear you.
Tyrell.
Okay, so that's version number one. So version number two is this one.
Hey, Tyrell.
Oh, me? Oh, okay. Yeah, what's up, Jordan?
Yeah, see?
See, I understand that one.
Yeah. Yeah, because they probably don't hear it a lot throughout the day.
They're like, oh, you caught me off guard, Tyrell? Oh, that is me.
Yeah.
I will respond to you.
Or even if they came, because they would always come out at the first option. If they came out the gates like, yo, like, listen, like, don't call me that.
Sure.
If they actually were just like, yo. Man,
yeah, some people just like,
not here.
Yeah.
Not here.
Yeah, calm down.
Yeah. I'd be like, all right, you know. Trust.
Even then, I'd be like, don't agree with you.
I'm going to still call you by your first name.
Yeah. Then there's option number three.
Hey, Tyrell.
I'm sorry?
Tyrell, can I... learn about the
homework. Get at the principal of all's office right now.
Yeah, like, I could. Yeah.
What's that going to do?
I've definitely heard that before.
What's that going to do?
I've definitely heard that before.
Like, it just, to me, okay, there's obviously a clear issue with students and teachers nowadays.
Yeah.
Right? You always see huge issues with disrespect and like arguments among students and teachers.
Yeah.
Now, I'm obviously not saying the teachers are at fault. Yeah. I'm not saying some of the students are at fault, but it does not help when they act like that to a student.
Yeah. Yeah.
It doesn't. Right. And that happens quite often.
I was definitely that shit kid. I feel like we talked about being a good kid and whatever in school the other time. I was a shitty kid to teachers sometimes. I can't lie. But like not to the point of like being like super disruptive, but I would say something like their first name or something just to get a rise out of them.
What up, Jerry?
Yeah. They just go to the principal's office. I'd be like, yo.
Yeah.
You know?
It's like our vice come by, check her schedule every time.
I was annoying as fuck.
But then like the principal would come by, like, hey guys.
What's up?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hope you have a good morning. How's God?
Yeah. Little man syndrome. He wasn't the big top dog, so he had to prove himself. That's
this is a theory here. Do you think people become like teachers because like they want to like relive school?
I've heard of that before.
Like relive. Say if they want to teach in high school, they relive high school.
I feel like a few maybe.
Yeah, there has to be
they're
some.
They're still stuck in that kid.
Yeah.
Like, because there's a lot of uncles like I know who are like big kids.
Yeah.
Who I feel like are like gym teachers.
Yeah.
I feel like some teachers actually wanted to become a teacher because they thought to themselves, you know, my school system wasn't the best. I want to become a teacher to make the school system better. And then when they get there, they're like, what a fucking waste.
Yeah.
Fuck this shit. Can't do shit here. Especially our school system.
Yeah,
literally.
They're fucking
new. They're, no future. That's awful. That's so bad.
It's hard to think about, yeah.
It is.
But I don't know. That's what pissed me off. I was just walking the dog and I was like, I almost said sick him to my dog.
Let him off the chain.
Had, get like, that a teacher. Teacher like that had a kid that you were like friends with like in the class but like their parent
no
it's my friend's teacher that. Like the person has that side
yeah
their dad was like our French teacher
oh really
I don't think so
like his dad taught at his school
that's Is that allowed? I would always see that in a couple schools and like, be like, yo, my dad's my teacher.
Yeah. I wouldn't doubt it if some schools are like, that's a conflict of interest in a sense. Because like you're teaching your child, so you could just benefit him.
True.
You know?
True, yeah.
Oh, that doesn't look like an F to me. If you just put another line down, that's actually an A.
Yeah, I'd be, you know.
Whoa, whoops. Whoa, scholarship?
How'd but I see how like maybe they were already a teacher first and then they put their school in, like, their kid into school.
Yeah.
I know how good it is.
Yep. I mean, there's got to be some parents out there who be picking on their kids.
Oh, yeah.
Just to make it seem like they're not related. Mm-hmm. All the students know.
Yeah.
They all know. So now all the students are wondering why this one guy just gets bullied by his dad.
Yeah.
But his dad doesn't know the students know. Yeah. So he's like, hey, Joe, stop acting like a bitch. Don't be doing that in my classroom. He's like, sorry, dad. Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Imagine that, like,
yeah,
yeah.
Your dad walks by.
Yeah,
what were you doing in the stairwell earlier?
Your friend group, like,
yeah.
That would kind of piss me off. I'd be honest. I wouldn't want my
let me ask you.
Gossip to be like,
yeah,
my kid, in science
class. Oh, ooh. They be knowing everything. Yeah, nah,
I don't know.
Yeah, that's
get home.
And they know how would that parent teacher meeting go? What if like the mom's divorced or something and like the dad's like the teacher?
Nah. Imagine this. Husband and wife, they're both teachers at your high school. Okay, hold on. The dad's a science teacher, the mom's an English teacher, but they're divorced. And now you have to have parent teacher meeting with each. So you go to the dad's with the mom's with the dad. Oh.
I'd leave the school.
Could you imagine how rough that would be?
Yeah, I would.
Just imagine parent teacher.
Yeah.
In general,
yeah.
So
that was rough.
So now, and you're failing both.
Yes. Oh! It's game over.
Now it's not even so much about you. It's even just about their marriage
and where
it failed.
Yeah. I guess dad's not teaching you right. Just shit like that. You inside comments.
He's behind his desk.
They're, like, trying to get you to be a scientist.
Yeah. It's not my fault you're trying to teach him poetry.
Poetry.
Yeah. And she's like, this is why we got divorced, Dave. And you're the student. You're just, once again, the meme.
Yeah, just.
Like, oh, fuck.
Shit.
Yeah, shit. This is happening again.
Yeah.
Yeah, that'd be awkward.
Yeah.
That'd be so awkward.
I couldn't stay in the same school. I don't know how some kids did it. Having their parents being their teacher.
Yeah,
but even like a good relationship though. Even if you're a good kid,
I guess.
But even that good kid, good grades, whatever, like, you know, good. It's just the fact of having your parent there all the time, getting driven home, and then your parent is there when you get home. Like, it's too much.
When you go to work, it's a nice break.
Yeah, exactly. Right? Yeah. I don't know.
You're grade 11, hormones on the rise.
Yeah, see?
You got a crush on Sally.
The name's always Sally.
Always Sally.
Maybe your mom or your dad is like, oh, you two are pairs.
Ew! If my mom is my wingman.
And she does. But both eyes, because she can't blink one.
Gotcha, honey.
And you're just like, shit. You got this crush on Sally, okay?
Yeah, okay.
You got this crush on Sally. Sally's got a crush on you too.
Okay. Sally knows the business. Okay.
Sally Salinger. Let's call her Sally Salinger. It's a pretty catchy name.
SS.
She's blonde. Like,
we need a full description.
Like, that's why they already want.
Sally Salinger. She's 2 months older than you.
Okay.
Okay. She kind of likes those younger guys, right?
All right.
Okay. 2 months younger. She's blonde, but she's kind of gotten into this, you know, new look of dyeing her hair. And she has started with brown highlights, but recently she's got into the red.
Switch. Okay.
She's all gotten right. to the red.
Shit.
Okay.
So you can't fumble the bag. You cannot fumble the bag.
No. Okay. You know this is your one chance to be the coolest guy here.
Yep.
All right. So you guys are hanging out every couple of days. You know, you still got your boys group. She's still got her gals group.
Yeah.
But every couple of days, you guys are having lunch together. Mm-hmm. You got an hour break. And all of a sudden, One day, your mom or dad who works at the school happens to see you on this little lunch date with Sally Salinger. And your mom or dad comes up to you and says, you know, how's that going? And you're at your locker and you're like, leave me alone. Like, no, stop embarrassing me. And they're like, look, I know next up in class, you have physical education. Now, hold on. Look, don't stop for a second. Just hear me out. They're talking about sex education today. And I really need you just to pay attention, just to really learn, you know, how reproductivity works. And as they're saying that, Sally hasn't left your locker.
Oh. I don't think you can come back from that.
Now, what's worse, the mom or the dad? Who would be worse in the situation? Ooh,
the dad. If the dad pulled up like that?
I think the dad, like, you'd think he'd be worse, but...
I would just think it would be worse because the girl wouldn't want to hear that from, like, from the dad, the you know? The mom would at least be, like, kind of be like, girl, yeah. Like, you know, like... You know? But yeah, if the dad pulled up, he was like, yo, like, listen.
It's been a hot day.
Sex ed. You know, and I know it, he's gonna be trying to like slick with Sally too, like sex ed. And Sally's just like,
yeah, she's weak, yeah, awkward.
Just, yeah, just
weird. Your dad, for some, his last class of the day is just gonna hear, Mr. Marcellin, come down to the office, please, Mr. Marcellin. No one's gonna understand why, but Sally felt awkward.
Sally felt awkward.
She's like, yeah, he's talking about sex yeah. in front of us. Oh, yo.
That how, was... how do you talk to the principal about that?
Sorry, this is middle school?
Be like, I was just...
No.
Damn!
It's like, guys, you gotta switch up. You gotta switch up.
Let me just take a drink.
Oh. No, yeah. we were pre.
Yeah,
it was... High school.
Legal age
high school.
Did a UE on there.
Oh, yeah.
But yeah, how would you explain that to the principal? Like, I was just telling him about sex ed.
They gotta be safe.
Yeah.
That's how I'd say. They yeah. gotta be safe.
Do you think that's enough? No, you're getting blasted. Oh, it has to be a football analogy. 100%.
Look, she's the quarterback.
So when she touches your balls for the snap.
She's the quarterback. You're the offensive lineman. You can't be letting her getting sacked like that. Sacked. And does the wink. And you're just like, Dad, stop, please. You're embarrassing me. And Sally's getting red.
Yeah, she's getting
red. She's getting red. She...
It's old.
It's old. Yeah. Yeah, I'll see you later, Jordan.
Wait, Sally, wait, no.
Oh my God. Awful. So he'd be getting blasted by the principal. There's no way around it.
You're not explaining that way out of there. No way.
You don't think the dad could be like, look, I just want the best for my son and his little girlfriend. You don't. Oh, if he says little girlfriend, that's not looking pretty. I want the best for my son and his little girlfriend.
I'd be like, why do you know so much? I'd be like,
yeah.
Stay out to your kids.
Yeah. Life. Just stick to science. Yeah.
You're a science teacher.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. Stick. The only biology you're doing out here is frogs and toads. That's it.
I just imagine that whole conversation when you're like talking to your son, just like the lean to listen to your son. And the legs crossed against the locker. Listen,
straight up dad pose. Yeah, and it's as he's walking. He's walking by, he doesn't bother to use your name. He does one of the cool on the locker. Hey kiddo.
Hey yo.
What's up? Hey yo kiddo. What's going on, Sally? How are you?
That's the pause. Like that's the wave. The three.
And you're trying to keep the convo cool, but you know it's coming off weird. The dad starts sweating because he knows.
Yeah.
He's like, ah, shit. You know what? I shouldn't have done this.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. I couldn't be a teacher. I couldn't be a
you know, if you do happen to be a teenager in a high school with a parent and it's not awkward like that in any way, good for you.
Yeah. I would want to hear about that, like that experience. I would too. Like, you know, mm-hmm. like how do you navigate your life?
8 billion people on the planet, bro. There's gotta be stories of awkward encounters with a student and a parent who works at their school.
Because like you were saying, there is that nice side. But what if you're a menace? What if you're a menace in school and your parents catching you lacking? Because they got time. Mm-hmm. That's their work. Mm-hmm. it's not like they're getting back from work. It's like, yo, I don't want to deal with this. That's their work. So they're just like, yo, I gotta act now. Like, you know,
your parent is working double time.
Yeah,
they work 80 hours a week.
Yeah, so
because they gotta watch your ass at home, and basically be your teacher at home, and then be a teacher at school, which is their real work. There's no rest. Yeah. There's no relaxation there. Nope. Mm-mm. Now, since we're on the school topic, were you, whenever there was a substitute teacher, was that an excuse to just be bad?
I'd be borderline. I wouldn't start the action, but I'd be a part of the action for sure. Like, I wouldn't purposely, like, be disruptive. But if it was, like, a substitute and we're watching a movie, fuck on my face. Like, well, come on now. You expect me to act right? You're putting on Teletubbies, and I'm supposed to, you know, have a worksheet for the whole movie. I'm not answering none of those questions. What are you talking about?
You just look at the substitute teacher, and you're like... Yeah, and they thought they had power.
Oh,
dog.
Yeah.
They thought. They
pulled out. Sometimes I felt sorry for them, though.
I did, too. And I got to be honest, not once was I ever bad to a substitute teacher.
Really, eh?
Not once.
Really?
Because I felt like I always understood they are coming to hostile territory.
Yeah, yeah.
You know? That's basically draft day for them. Being a substitute teacher is their day to show up and be like, I can do this.
Yeah.
I always felt bad for them. Mm-hmm. So I always made sure to just kind of sit in my seat and not say a word. Yeah. I didn't want to.
Even on like a movie day.
Yeah.
Yeah, eh?
Yep.
No, I'm sorry. If there was actual work to do, I'd be fine. But if it's a day where like they're just sitting at their desk, like they'd be on their phone. I'm not watching the movie. I'm not doing the thing.
You're doing
and
your,
then they'd be like, yo, like pay attention.
Don't.
I literally.
What? To the movie?
What?
I will say this, though. Every now and then we had a substitute teacher. And if I knew we had a substitute teacher, sometimes, depending on the class, I was not showing up. Yeah. I was like, hey, look, I'm just not going to class. Because if we have a substitute, I know we're not going to be learning anything.
Yeah, it's true.
There, you know, obviously, there's different types. If you had a substitute teacher for gym, you obviously know that for gym, you'd be able to play whatever you wanted.
Yeah, whatever the fuck you wanted, yeah.
If I'm going to substitute teacher, or sorry, if I'm going to history, I know my substitute teacher is probably going to be like, you probably have some work to do in that booklet.
Yeah, yeah. 100%.
No.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
For sure.
So, I don't know. Yeah, but I feel bad for them.
It is true, though. Do you think, like, because I don't know how it works now, but before, people just worked as substitute teachers. Like, they would get called to this school and then this school and that school. Like, do you think they would perfect their craft after, like, a certain amount of time? Like, I'm asking, like, it's not easy to deal with a rowdy class.
No.
Not at all.
No.
But, like, when you think, like, when you learn some, like, tips and tricks... Of like how
you have to,
yeah,
you would have to,
because like for me, like once I heard that my name the next day, be like your name's on the board, like Jordan, Kyle, Thomas. Once your name's up there on the whiteboard or on the blackboard,
that stays. And tomorrow, your actual teacher's gonna be like, "What the hell is this about?"
Oh, trust.
Yeah,
I tried to erase this. I can't even lie, and I got caught because. It left the actual like, what is it? The space of my name, you know?
Yeah.
She's like, why is this erased? Because I didn't erase the rest of the name.
You immediately went like, I can't see anything. Yeah. I'm blind.
No, like, you know, I was definitely pulling that one.
I gotta say it one more time. It's stuff like that I felt bad for.
Yeah,
I did. I really did.
It's true. I don't know. I don't know how they did it. I don't know.
Didn't our school? We had and she was there for a while. Ryan Gosling's mom.
Yeah, she
really.
In our English class.
Yeah,
she was a student teacher, and then she didn't tell us until the end.
Yeah.
No way.
Yeah, Ryan Gosling's mom. She was a teacher at our school for 6 months.
No way.
Yeah.
She's
yeah.
Our English field.
Wow. That's crazy.
She was really nice.
Why am I blanking? Oh, isn't that the teacher who like mortally hated me?
How'd you
Miss Ramson?
I hate Miss Ramson.
Yeah, Miss Rams. Yeah, it is Miss Ramson. Yeah, she's a bitch. Bitch. She was.
She's watching the videos.
Good. I hope so. she would pick on me and Tyler every single day. Really? She had the opportunity to. Yeah.
Wow.
She was one of those teachers, okay, where if me and Tyler, okay, me and Tyler, in all honesty, we were known for being a little rowdy. We could get a little.
So you weren't bad to the substitutes. You're bad
to the real ones. Real teachers. Although, if you actually knew who we were, teachers liked us.
Really?
Oh, sure.
Yeah.
Like, you guys didn't do humor, but.
We were coasting.
You were like, yeah. Bad kids.
No, we weren't. But we
fucking with each other too much.
We would mold our attitudes depending on the teacher, though. So if we knew the teacher was gonna be like, hey, you boys, we would do that. If we knew the teacher was gonna be a bitch, then
I've never seen an all caps come out of someone's mouth. Like, this guy capitalized words out of his mouth. Like, how does that make sense?
Bitch.
Damn.
Ooh, okay.
You say it as if like two were good.
Yeah.
If we knew the teacher was gonna be a bitch, then we would mold our attitude to kind of calm down.
It.
We would tone it down.
Reflect it,
So with Rammy, we with Ramson. We knew she didn't like us.
Yeah.
So
walk in the classroom and she would already be pissed. And I'm like, they didn't even open their mouth.
Yeah. Yeah.
But it's the way they walk in or something.
So in her class, it got to the point where me and Tyler realized, all right, you know what? We can't even speak to one another. So we would go into class and not say shit. But then we had this fucking kid, Brian. He would dick around all class.
Yeah.
And Ramson was like, oh, ha, 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 you're so funny.
She pitied him.
But then me and Tyler, we would literally drones, bro.
Yeah. And she'd still be like, yo, shut up.
Yeah. What the hell are you doing? Are you guys talking through minds? You're like, what the fuck are you talking about?
Lost the room.
Yeah, oh, bro. It was so bad. So I'll say this. She hated me and Tyler. Yeah. I think she hated me a little bit more, though.
Really, eh?
Way more.
She hated me so much that in grade 12, we had assignments, and she had an awful way of grading assignments where what she would do is she would assign like 10 assignments in the first semester. Okay. You would hand them all in, and at the end, she would mark all of them. Somehow, some way, all 10 of my assignments were never handed in. All 10 of my assignments were never handed in. So I got a 30%. And that's when things got bad. It got so bad that my mom actually got involved and had on the phone arguments with her.
Good.
And that teacher still had the audacity to root me out as the cause of all the problems.
What?
So what happened was it was right before the second semester. So we still.
I wasn't in your grade 12 class.
Sorry?
I was in what's
your name? Fisher?
Yeah.
True.
In
the second semester, we had 4 months left of grade 12. Beautiful.
Yeah.
What happened was just before the second semester started, I'm walking down the hallway. I'm walking down the hallway with Tyler, Hayden, and a couple other people.
Jesse,
isn't it? Probably. And I see her talking to two other teachers, and as I'm walking down the hall, she sees me coming. She's literally gossiping about me to other fucking teachers. As we're walking by, I literally heard her talk about how she blasted my mom, and she set the record straight that I am a rowdy kid, I'm disrespectful and everything. As I'm walking by, I said to her, "Don't you dare disrespect me or my mother."
Good.
I walked away and I walked into her class. I shit you not.
She came in.
Oh gosh. Oh god.
How do you think your ass touched it?
Go to the office. Okay.
He knew.
Okay, so I got two quick stories about the same teacher, all right?
Okay.
Okay, so in grade 11, when she was somewhat liking us, it just all went downhill after that.
Yeah.
So she conveniently, she had to have done this on purpose.
Yeah.
She put me and Tyler, the desks were squared of four. She put me and Tyler and our ex-girlfriends at the same desk.
See, that makes me wonder, did she think you guys are still together? Like, how long ago was the breakup from that point? Like, from breakup to that point?
2-3 months.
Okay. You sense. As a teacher, you sense. You know. Yeah. You know the vibe.
So, first story here. I can't remember how we got onto this conversation. And the class was fucking awkward when this happened.
Oh, gosh.
She was doing attendance. She says to Tyler, because Tyler's last name is Goldman.
Okay.
But Goldman with two N's. Mm-hmm. Okay. He's actually German. He's part German. Mm-hmm. She says to Tyler, are you Jewish? Man, this is getting weird. And Tyler's like, no. Tyler's like, no, why? She's like, well, your last name is Goldman. Okay. He's like, no, I'm actually part German, to be honest with you. She's like, oh, okay. She goes, Tyrell, are you Jewish?
Oh, God. What? What?
So then I said, no, I'm half Italian and Jamaican Guyanese. And she's like, oh, ready?
Oh, God.
Oh, it's just because of your curly hair, I thought you were Jewish.
So other cultures can't have
curly hair?
What?
And bro, the whole class was
kind of like,
what the fuck is happening? Yeah.
What was she trying to be funny? Like, what was her vibe when she was like saying that? Was she kind of just like,
are you Jewish? Yeah. It was more like, are you Jewish?
Ew.
What the fuck?
No. Ew.
Oh, okay. No problem. I thought you were.
So then a couple days goes by. And we're reading one of Shakespeare's bullshit stories. It wasn't
Juliet.
No, it might have been Macbeth.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
Macbeth. And what she wanted to do is she wanted every section, so every four people in their groups, to read a passage and then discuss it with one another. Yeah. So that was me, Tyler, and our exes. So we start talking about it.
Mm-hmm.
And in all honesty, we are all kind of on good terms.
Okay,
so we're kind of just joking around. Yeah, you're just
chilling. Yeah.
So Tyler and my ex, they're kind of talking. Me and Tyler's ex, we're kind of talking. I like to be a funny dude. I'm just making jokes, and she's laughing away.
Mm-hmm.
What does this fucking broad do?
Oh gosh.
And broad, I mean by our fucking teacher.
Oh gosh.
I shit you not.
No.
Tyrell and blah blah blah, are you guys dating? So Tyler,
hold on before you go deeper, how old is this woman? I need to picture her.
She would have been at the time 30s.
I was gonna say late 35 to 40.
This is sounding like an old woman.
She's
here.
She's like maybe 5'2", heavier set.
And you said she's like East Indian?
I think she was East. Yeah.
Or West Indian? Yeah.
She feels like she's got that name. She wants to
fight no bit. Are you guys dating? And yo, we looked at each other and we were like, no, we're just laughing. We're joking around. And Tyler just like looks at me and goes like,
yeah, what? Does she? This is sounding like she's teaching like an elementary school. Like that would make an elementary kid embarrassed.
Like, thought we were like children.
Yeah. Like, as a kid, I would be embarrassed, but what were you, 16, 17?
16, 17, yeah.
At that age, I'd be like,
what the fuck you doing?
Yeah, like, what?
You know those female teachers that befriend the other girls?
Yeah.
She was, like, one of those.
That's a good description.
They're fucking talking.
Okay, yeah. Okay.
I have many more, but those are two of the big ones.
Damn. Oh, my gosh.
I had another teacher like that, but I liked Miss Fisher. Some people didn't.
I don't think I've ever had like a bad teacher horror story like that.
Oh, it was bad.
Yeah, that's bad.
Mr. Watt, yep.
Because he gave me a 51.
He's
horrible. Yeah. I think three or four people almost failed.
Why? You know who else was...
He was a good teacher, but for university.
The other teacher was really bad. The geography dude.
Dimitri?
Awful. I couldn't stand that guy.
Really?
Horrible.
Yeah, Dimitri's an idiot. If you're watching this, you're an idiot. There's a couple of teachers that are like, oh my God, why are you in this profession? Because you cannot handle it.
Stegner, but I felt bad for her. She's a computer science. She had a lash.
Yes, she really? Did.
And she like she ended up just, breaking her wrist or something. She was off for like 5-6 months.
We coasted.
Wow.
We subbed for like half a year.
Wow.
And we just coasted. Blessed. Yeah.
Damn.
I felt bad for her because she had some students that are just brain dead and she brain dead. So yeah,
just I feel like I was cool with most of my teachers.
So were we.
Yeah, for sure. But like that goes back to the breezing through school thing. I would go to all my classes, I just wouldn't do my shit.
Yeah.
So I'd talk to the teachers like, yo, what's up? Like, yeah. Like, I would literally, like, have conversations with the teachers. Like, yo, what'd you do last night?
Mm-hmm.
You were drinking, eh?
Yeah.
Like, shit like that. I would just chat them up.
Yeah.
And be like, all right, time to do work.
Careful of Ramzan, though. She might think you're Jewish.
Yeah, like, what the fuck? Like, what is that? Like, what is...
I hope when Hill Park closed, she didn't get a job somewhere else.
She
didn't get another job,
yeah, for real. She did?
I think she did. I think most did.
Ugh.
Because I saw, like, Miss Fisher, like, 2 years after... We were talking about. I was like, "Hey, did you get like?" She's just fighting where all the teachers went.
Yeah.
And shit. And then I played frisbee with Miss Smith. She's at.
Yes, I remember her.
At Churchill or whatever.
Yeah. Okay. But,
wow. Damn. Yeah.
She says, "Yeah, it's hard."
It's hard.
Hard to get a teacher, even though.
Yeah. I can't be a teacher. Fuck that.
No.
Yeah. No.
Then you gotta do your marking after hours.
Yeah.
Hold that fucking.
It's a lot.
Nah, no thanks.
Yeah. I gotta say, this is what I told myself when I was like 16. I don't want to do work at work. Like, that's literally my motto, and I've lived by that since I've graduated high school.
The world ain't working like that.
I'll be honest. I'm doing pretty good right now. Can't even lie to you. I'm doing fair pretty enough. Good
you
right
are.
Now.
Work at work.
I do not want to do work at work. Listen, I want to be a pilot. You're not flying that plane. You're these not guys, flying that.
You're hitting buttons.
Yeah, you're hitting buttons.
Put on a movie.
Should we make shit when I'm flying the plane?
They're like, you gotta tell them how the flight's going. It's going good.
Yeah, you're blessed, you know. Buckle up the seats.
Well, the plane just.
That's what I'm saying. All you gotta do is take off and landing.
Basically. Yeah.
All the pilot, the rest. Obviously, if there's like turbulence and stuff. Yeah. I'm chilling. I don't know. I want to do work at work. I'm telling you.
Yo, you heard it here. If you're working at work, you're doing it wrong. Yeah.
And teachers are working at work and they're working at home.
Yeah.
I'm not getting paid.
Yeah, they're doubling down.
They ain't getting overtime.
My dad used to teach for like medical.
Really?
He did so much work at home. He's like, fuck this.
Yeah. Not worth it.
Series, like, I'm done.
Burns you out.
Yeah.
3-4 hours making slides, PowerPoints.
Yeah,
like,
see?
Chair, right?
So. See, yeah, if I was super passionate about something like that, I could do that for a little bit, but not my career.
He's a good teacher, yeah.
Yeah, not my career. But like when you are passionate, that's when you're a good ass teacher.
Yeah, that's different, yeah.
So
because you actually care about what you're teaching.
Exactly.
My aunt's been like teacher for a while. She works mad.
Really,
yeah.
Horrible. Damn. Like if I could teach a class on like anime, I'd go.
I'm in.
PowerPoints.
Are there like video game like scholarships?
Yeah, there's shit like that,
gamers now, like.
I mean, there's...
There's everything.
Bro, you can learn Klingon as a profession.
Yeah. You can learn how to do laundry.
There,
literally.
Yeah. I think... There's teachers for that. I think it's... I can't remember what school. I want to say Georgia or Columbia for some reason. Mm-hmm. But you can take a Batman course where you literally learn how to be Batman and everything he knows.
Wow.
Well, they're doing a Drake one at York. There's a Drake course.
Well, what do they teach? What do you mean Drake course?
It's being introduced because I guess there's schools in the States that have like a Beyonce course, and it's like a whole history. And like, you know how you do like a study on like certain like Viking or like a
historic okay, yeah, story yeah, yeah.
or something
yeah,
like that?
Yeah, yeah.
It's kind of like that.
Huh.
So you do like a study on like
what the
musician. But
heck?
Yeah, so there's one at York.
Yo!
In Toronto for Drake, and it's like new, fairly new, but.
So lesson number one, get a ghostwriter.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I will say in this day and age, you can make money off anything.
Anything, so why not?
I think it's more of like just their era of like
what yeah. the OVO yeah. course.
Yeah.
Like, think they're calling it that? 100%.
I don't know.
The OVO course?
You can only, sure only cover, take like, it in October?
Not just a thing, like his business, how yeah. like in...
See, okay.
When, so that's when good. Can you take it?
Only October.
That's it.
That's it.
If you don't put in your application, yeah. it's gone.
What do you say?
Here?
Yeah, what does it say in the guide, man?
Oh, DSTRKT district.
Which
huh.
district do you
want? Hey. Hold on.
What, it says something different on this side.
Eight.
No? Eight district?
Eight district, yes. It's eighth district.
Oh.
I got it in LA.
Okay.
And it's
okay.
like this guy's clothing brand.
Okay, that's dope, man.
And I'm like, I have to buy this because
yeah,
I love the
it's
color.
It's kind of clean, yeah.
You
yeah.
were about to roast.
Yo, I'll be honest though. I was going to start off the gates of like, I have so many sweaters. I don't know what the fuck it says on it. Yeah. So I was just like, shit, like, it's dope, but like, what does it say?
When we were in LA, I walked by, we were on the strip. Where was it? It was Melrose. We were on Melrose okay. Strip, and I was walking down, and because basically it's all either really named brands or it's brands you've never heard of.
See, that's the stores I like to go into.
Yeah. So I walk in, and guy's got this hanging up.
Mm.
He's like, "You like it, bro?" And I'm like, "Yeah, it's super nice, man." He's like, "You try. You let me know what you think." I'm like, all right. So I threw it on. I'm like, fuck yes, I gotta get this. So I dropped it. I think like 120 on it.
That's not too bad, it's not honestly.
Bad. It's not.
You get
bad.
A fucking Nike jacket,
yeah.
and it's the same price.
It's so got like a kangaroo pouch.
Okay, that's dope.
It's got pockets too. little like strings so you can tighten it.
Yeah,
it's pretty sick. It's not too bad. Stitching is keeping up too. Like
you've had this for what? A couple years, right?
Since 2019. The beginning of 2019.
Damn.
So that's like 3 years ago.
I'm going to have to go to LA.
Uh-huh. yeah, so.
But what you got for us?
Yeah, what's going on, Hayden?
Yes, it's just from like the new Lord of the Rings.
Yes.
Like, thing for Prime.
Looks interesting.
So I was going to get your thoughts on like movies now doing series. Lord of the Rings, you got Boba Fett, you got like the Mandalorian, like
I think they're doing a good job.
It's gonna start into like a new
yeah.
You got the Witcher, they're like movie quality,
mm-hmm.
but they're
mm-hmm.
shows.
I will say it's way easier to watch like a show of something than it is to watch a movie.
And they're not like 20-minute episodes.
Yeah. Which I don't know why. Why is it easier like that? I need a psychologist to explain that to me. I don't wanna watch a hour and a half movie, but let me watch 10 45-minute episodes.
Yeah, there like, has you know? To be a reason why. Because I don't know. I'm still a movie guy.
Really?
I'll still take a movie over sure. TV show.
Really?
Just because I think for me, movies, it has that like the cinematic feel.
Yeah.
You know?
Like part one, part two type shit, part three. Like, say there's one movie, make it into three that are like 2 hours long.
Yes.
Or like the Justice League. Like,
yeah.
Split
into six parts. Yeah.
That'd be crazy. Yeah.
I will say though about TV shows, it gives you more room to play. Mm-hmm. You know,
yeah.
with a story, you can 100%. Do a lot more. The only thing you not fail, but where you kind of falter with a TV show is the amount of filler shit you get.
Yeah.
That's the only thing.
It's going to be a lot.
Because with a movie, you're forced to
not
do
gotta,
filler.
Yeah. You got to give it up your all.
Mm-hmm.
That's true.
So it's kind of like it's like, what would you rather have? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Would you rather be dedicated to a time crunch where anything important needs to be told in 2 hours? Or would you rather be able to say, I got like 12 episodes, each an hour long. I can kind of play around.
get some bullshit.
Yeah.
Give me that filler shit.
Like, shoot me in the head.
Yeah.
Yeah. But that is true. You give and take, right?
Yeah.
If you like that fast paced, you know, what's going to happen next, let's go movie.
Yeah.
If you want that, let me know more about the world. Mm. Let's go show.
See, I forgot what I was going to say, but pretty much I don't know why, but lately it's taken me so long to watch a movie. Like, say if you recommended something, like, yo, like, this is an amazing watch.
I just don't dive in yet.
And really, yeah,
like,
20
minutes in, I'm like touching my phone. I'm like,
yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. But like, just even to like put it on though, it's hard for me. Even though I know, like, yo, this movie's good, I'm still like, eh, let me just
really?
Look through the TV shows. It. Yeah, yeah.
Really?
It's because it's the first 10 minutes. I'm going to be straight honest right now. Yeah. It's the first 10 minutes and I'm just like, I don't want to get through this nonsense.
Actually,
and then it gets good.
I believe it's supposed to be in the first 10 minutes of the movie.
Yeah.
If you are not captivated, there's like a 50 or 60% chance you, or no, it's like an 80% chance you won't like the movie as a whole.
Really, eh?
Yeah, something like that.
So like any other thing, if you don't impress,
Is that why in scary movies they always do like the killing at first and then they gotta figure out who the fuck that
is? Because they want to invest you into the film.
That's why they make scary movies, because the risk, the profit to rewards, ginormous.
True. Makes sense.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like the first Paranormal they made for like 15 grand.
Yeah, like the budget was mil. yeah it was crazy,
so
that's wild.
But that's because it was a new concept though.
That's certainly so why
people were just like, oh shit, like,
yeah, let's check it out.
Yeah,
I'm not a horror movie fan. I
fucking love horror movies. Do you? Yeah. Yes, I love them.
See, I won't watch them just because for me,
yeah,
like I'm a story guy, so like they don't have story for me. I'm like,
100% that story's nonsense.
Yeah, yeah,
it's half of them are just fucking funny. Like literally.
I love the Paranormal.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, that's the thing, right? Is I heard like the first couple are like actually pretty good, but now they're just dumb.
Now they're just doing whatever.
It's the fifth one where the teen is in the house.
It's like a Spanish one or something like that, or maybe I'm wrong.
She has like a boyfriend. And, like,
was it on Prime?
I don't know if it was on Prime, but it's the funniest shit.
Yeah.
Because the boyfriend is just so funny, and then obviously ends up dying.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
But it's probably my favorite one.
Like, there was one on Prime before you dive deeper. Mm-hmm. There was one on Prime. I don't know if it was the same one. But I turned it off in like 20 minutes. Like
it was bad.
It was so bad. And I will sit through a scary movie. Even if I don't get scared, nothing, I will sit through it. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But I turned it off. It was like so bad. Wasn't funny. Wasn't fucking like.
There's no comedy.
I don't even want the comedy. Just like I laugh at things
that are stupid,
that are terribly executed.
Yes. Yes. So I get it. That, and often they are.
Yeah. But like. How terribly they executed, I couldn't even laugh at it.
Mm.
I was like, what are you doing?
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I want to find the name of it, but it's on Prime anyways.
Okay.
But sorry, what were you going to say?
No, I was just going to say, like, I'm a movie head.
Yeah.
So I will watch anything. Mm-hmm. I will even watch something that is bad so I can say to myself after, I've experienced it.
Mm-hmm.
I have knowledge in this genre.
True.
And I know what not to do in the future if I make a movie. That's why I like watching bad movies sometimes.
True.
And something I've really like kind of inside of the movie realm is there's a saying that, you know, make all the bad movies you want, but don't be a bad actor. And there are tons of movies I've seen that are just shit, but the acting is good.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, it's true.
There's always got to be something good that comes out of a bad movie.
Yeah, yeah.
Always.
Well, it's kind of like the Reynolds and The Rock. Like, no offense, but that Red Nose only did good because it's got three.
Yeah, it's got, yeah, that superstars.
Horrible.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And they're getting like a sequel.
The story
they're getting a sequel?
Of course they are.
It's so bad.
I think it only did good, though, because it came out on Netflix.
Well, that too.
Yeah.
Like, yeah.
The big name actors.
Yeah.
Netflix, because it's easy.
Mm-hmm.
And everyone just loves popcorn flicks.
Yeah.
That's all people like.
Yeah.
No one likes to be challenged anymore when they watch a movie. You know? I watched, and I guarantee you, people would be like, what the hell is that? On Netflix the other day, I watched a movie called The Power of the Dog.
I don't know if I've seen that.
I was like, I watched some shit and scrolled through.
It just came out a couple weeks ago. It's Benedict Cumberbatch.
Okay.
And
Kristen might have saw a preview for it.
Yeah, actually. Kristen Dunst. Huh. And it takes place in the early 1900s. It's 1925.
Yeah.
And Benedict Cumberbatch essentially is so they're ranchers.
Mm-hmm.
But you can tell the way the story is built in the 1800s before the 1900s started, because they're in their 40s around this time.
Yeah.
You could tell they were maybe like cowboys of some sorts. But now times are changing and now they're like farmers and ranchers and stuff like that. But Benedict Cumberbatch's character is finding it hard to transition into this new way of life because he imagines that a man is supposed to be big and strong and alpha male and, you know, like stuff like that. But as the movie, should I say anything? As the movie goes on, you end up finding out that truly deep inside, he's actually the quite opposite because he's gay. So he wants...
That was wasn't expecting that.
He wants to be, you know, kind of a little more like...
You want
to
believe the soonest over.
Yeah, so he has to overcompensate for that big, gruff, you know? And it's just...
I will say the concept doesn't sound bad.
No.
But you're saying it wasn't good?
No, I liked it. Oh, but what saying... It wasn't the best movie I've ever seen. Because it's just the atmosphere and the tone of the story is not necessarily for me. Okay. But as a whole, whole, it's good. The movie has a 90 out of 100 because it's narrative. So usually it's movies like... Yes. Movies like that will be considered for an Oscar. Right?
Yeah.
But why I even mention that is because it's not a popcorn flick, so people won't care.
Yeah.
Often people won't care about that, it's like you know?
That Prisoners movie you were telling us.
With Jake Gyllenhaal.
Guess what I'm starting to see it on?
Where?
Netflix is trending.
Really?
Wow. Like, it's been out for how long? And now it's just...
The one we talked about with Jake Gyllenhaal, Hugh Jackman.
Oh, yeah. I remember you. Yeah. Oh,
shit. That's on Netflix, man. That's not a popcorn flick.
But now it's on their page. You can see they're starting to push it.
It's a great film.
It looks good.
Prisoners, eh? Maybe I'll check that.
Yeah. But yeah, I find that's why maybe to kind of get back to what he was saying about films kind of going to TV shows now. Yeah. I feel like movies may be struggling a little bit because if it's not a popcorn flick like a Marvel movie, no one really wants to give it the time of day.
Yeah.
Whereas with TV shows, people are always finding an excuse to be like, I need to watch a new show.
Yeah. Even just like in the realm of Netflix, once I see like limited series, I'm just like, yo, this must be good.
Bop.
I'm going to throw that on. So, hey.
Man.
Could be right.
Netflix will make anything, too.
Yeah.
Anything.
They stepped on like I was like, holy shit. They've made that. Holy. I started going down the originals. I'm like, they have so many Netflix originals.
Well, the reason why they make so many originals, limited series, TV shows, or movies, is because they pour like over $3 billion a year.
Everyone's making a fucking...
So it's like they just toss money at you.
Yeah. So essentially Netflix, they're kind of like a fountain.
Yeah.
You know, you scoop up some water and take it with you. Mm-hmm. This is essentially what they do with money. So the reason why they're not afraid is because at the end of the day, what they're getting back in return is more than $3
billion. And like 100%, like even if it's bad, people are going to watch it. It's crazy.
That's why.
Yeah.
So they don't, that's why so many shows get canceled on Netflix.
Yeah.
Because they're not afraid to try.
Yeah.
Put one out, didn't work.
Move on. Yeah.
Especially that's COVID, they're probably like.
Oh my god.
Bitches.
They execute. What are you doing? Yeah. You're watching TV.
One thing I hate about Netflix is their layout, though.
Their algorithm.
Yes, it's bad. Everything to do with that. What are you doing?
Mm-hmm.
Well, my mom's, I'm like, I've never seen this.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah. I will say this, the algorithm is bad.
Mm-hmm.
I do like their layout better than
Disney's.
I find the HUD too, the menu system, is awful for Disney. Slow. Oh my god.
I do like
god.
How they have like Marvel and Pixar.
You know who else is super bad though? Crave is awful. Crave is just a dump. It's so bad.
I'm trying to remember because I don't have Crave right now, but I did. I don't remember.
Like when you click a show on Netflix, right? It's like load, pop.
And it shows like more like.
Yeah.
I love that shit.
Crave is you click on a movie. It's like load, start. It's like, golly. Oh my God.
That 30 seconds.
And fast forwarding and rewinding. Forget it. Forget it. You might as well start from the fucking
beginning. I know you're paying like $30 a month too. I know you got the HBO Plus movies plus.
No, I only do. I only do Crave plus HBO. I don't do Stars or anything like that. I think it's 20.
Yeah, I see that.
Netflix used to be $6.99.
Yeah, Netflix used to be cheap.
Now it's like what, $18?
Yeah. Now they're raising again.
Yeah,
they're raising in the States. Yeah.
People laugh, and I'm like, everybody has seven people on one account.
Yeah.
They're trying to make do for that.
Damn. Yep, that's what it is.
I get it.
Yeah. But like, yeah, you guys are 30, fine.
You over 30, I'm sorry.
Yeah, that's where it's the point. I was like, ugh.
Like, y'all
I'm going to go back to streaming my shit.
Yeah. Y'all are fine. You don't need to keep raising your fucking prices. It's
there's a certain price people will pay.
Yeah. But anyways, to get back to the whole TV show movie thing, I think it is a little...
Like, are they making more money now?
I don't know. I mean, when I know once again, it's a popcorn flick, and it's just.
Wait, what is?
Spider-Man.
Okay.
It's Marvel. I get it. It's a superhero, but like, look at the numbers that thing did in the theaters.
Yeah.
And imagine if some of the world, like us, wasn't constantly being locked down. Could you imagine how much more money it would have made?
They would have been. Yeah.
I could have seen that movie get into the 2 billion mark.
Yeah, I probably would have went to see it again.
Yeah,
to be honest. Yeah, like it.
I thoroughly enjoyed that.
Yeah.
So
I just watched the Spider Verse actually recently.
Oh, the cartoon. Yeah, that's a good one. So, I think that at least with TV shows, what you can do is don't get rid of like movies and theatrical releases, but with TV shows, it gives you the opportunity to start diving deeper if you want to know more. Right? Mm-hmm. Like you mentioned, Mandalorian and Boba Fett. I know the Skywalker saga well. Yeah. But I don't know what Boba Fett did during his time. So why not give me a show? You know? Those so gaps, yeah. I think it works.
Yeah. Well, what would you guys name your TV show if you had your own TV show?
Well, because I'm predicting next is going to be a Harry Potter TV show.
You think? Well, actually? I didn't think
they would do like Star Wars like that big, like they're starting to do a lot more.
Why not? They're already making a game.
Yeah.
Would it be the same original cast, you think?
Oh god, no. I think they dive into like just that family or like
true.
Not even like their type of world.
Does Harry Potter work like there's thousands of years of history?
That's what I mean. Like it could be
that,
like
there is, way. I would want to see what's that blonde guy's name? I'm trying to remember it. I forget his actor's name and it. What was it?
Tom Felton.
No, yeah. Him, I would love to see like more of him.
Like just his family.
Yeah, his family.
Dad,
yeah.
Him growing up, you know, walking
that would be, that'd be a crazy story. Hmm. Yeah, you're right.
Because you do it.
So, yeah, yeah, like there's so much history. Well, look what they're doing now. Game of Thrones.
What's going on with that?
Yeah, so
they scrapped that 30 mil or something.
So they scrapped a $30 million project that was supposed to be about the original Long Night. That's so the first White Walker War. So now we're getting the dragon, the House of the Dragon. So it's about how the Targaryens come to Westeros and take over. We're getting that this summer.
Oh, shit.
I believe.
Oh, really?
Yeah. We're getting that this summer. And apparently, George has signed off to do 8 more.
Really?
He can't even fit.
Hey, I know.
Yo, George can't even finish his fucking books. And
he has
to finish this last book.
Is it just one more?
I think it's just one book left.
You think he's just chilling? He has to be just chilling. He's like, yo, I'm getting all this money.
He's just done. Like, he's not in that mode. Like,
it's true, like, though. You got to be.
Thing. Like, don't force him back in. I got to end it.
But he seems wildly invested.
So invested.
He's so invested into the shows that it's just kind of like. Of course. And, you know, it is clear as day that he was not happy with how season 8 ended. He also apparently pleaded for 10 to 12 seasons.
Yeah.
And
yeah, you were saying
he wanted 10 at least.
Yeah, and it never ended up happening. Man. I think even 10 would have been fine. You,
I think
you know?
I like around season 6 when they start coming out with those contracts. If
they're mm-hmm. 10. Mm-hmm. I'm telling you right now, it's because Dave and DB got signed on to a Star Wars trilogy. And they were so excited that they just wanted to get Game of Thrones done and out of the way. And boy, is karma a bitch, because you treat Game of Thrones the way you did, and then you lost your contract to Star Wars. So, yep. Yeah, eat it.
Yep.
You deserve
that's
that.
That's what happens.
You deserve that.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, like, that's the thing, right? With Game of Thrones is everyone wants to know more than just Game of Thrones.
Yeah.
They want to know about the thousands of years before the TV show, because there's tons of history.
Yeah, there's so much,
you know?
You could dive deeper on, yeah.
People want to know what happens after Game of Thrones. Now, if it, will we ever get that? Who knows? But
I doubt that.
Yeah, it'll if we ever get a continuation of Game of Thrones, it'll be 10 years after its final season. So it'll be 2029. That's when they would announce something. Yeah, I could see them doing it, like them bringing back like a reunion, mm-hmm. kind of like a new brand new story. But it'll be a long time for them. Yeah. But that's why, all right, dive into the history.
Yeah.
So now show more of what makes Game of Thrones what it is.
Yeah.
There's no matter how you feel about how the show ended, there's no doubt it's
a Lord of the Rings. You can make a game out of it. You could do so much. You could make it into a movie and mm-hmm. have characters.
Do you think there'll ever be a game?
Yeah.
Yeah. I miss, okay, you ever played Lord of the Rings on PlayStation 2?
Yeah.
It had cutscenes from the movies.
Yeah.
Remember those games?
Yeah.
It's like, why did they stop doing it? Yeah. I love them.
You could make a Game of Thrones game, no problem.
Yeah.
I mean,
like, I'm going here.
They do have one. Have you guys
Isn't there like a mobile game? Is that what you're about to talk about?
I've seen on PC, it's always...
Have you guys played the Telltale games where it's all story interactive?
Yeah.
They made a Telltale game for Game of Thrones.
And it just follows the same story?
Kind of like The Walking Dead type.
Yes, exactly like that. Yeah, and it follows the story of a northern family who are under the Stark banner. And their family ends up getting ripped apart the same way the Starks do.
Really?
Yeah. It's supposed to take place between season 3 and 4.
Oh.
And they were supposed to do a continuation, but it just never happened. Yeah.
Well, it's just not my style. I don't think it's many.
Yeah.
I did like it. I do like that type of game. But
see, they're making a what you call two. What's that game we played? The Snowy Mountain.
Snowy Mountain.
Had the one character. Had the actor he plays.
Oh my god! Until Dawn.
Until Dawn.
Oh, that's a
two coming.
They're making
two. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Until Dawn 2.
Yeah, they're supposed to be. Yeah.
Look that up right now.
Yeah.
That
was supposed to be a thing time ago, but I heard they.
A couple days ago, I saw something about it.
I heard they scrapped it, but maybe they brought it back. But that was like right after its popularity.
Hmm.
They said there's going to be a 2, and then there wasn't, and then maybe they're saying it again.
That's a great horror game.
Yeah, yeah, that was good. That was good. That was really good.
Yeah. Because it's a butterfly effect.
Yeah.
Anything 100%. You do changes, yeah. Right?
Oh.
Well, have you heard of that Star Wars Eclipse game?
No.
Yeah, so it's supposed to be another narrative game like that.
Really?
Yeah, it'll be played like that. Like, have you played Detroit Become Human?
No.
Okay, it's...
Oh, okay. It's still like on the ropes. People are...
Yeah. Eh?
Okay.
But that would be crazy if they made another one.
So that's another version of storytelling now.
Yeah.
If you have people who are not huge into playing video games,
mm-hmm.
okay, and they still love the worlds and want to know more about it, why not make a video game that's more story-driven?
Yeah.
So now all you have to do is like quick time events or make certain decisions. That can get TV watchers and movie watchers into a video game where they don't actually need to be playing.
Yeah, 100%.
So
they've been working on another game because they didn't expect it to sell actually how well it did.
The fuck? Drop everything else you're doing and make another one. What?
Yeah, we live in a world of entertainment.
Yeah.
Anything will sell.
Still,
so.
Like, it's not like denied or confirmed.
Yeah, it's just kind of like, middle ground. It's in limbo. Yeah.
Like, yo, you need to make one. They're like, oh, fuck, okay, like, maybe after this, maybe not.
What company made it?
Oh, fuck. Just...
No, it's all good. Yeah, because that was a good game. Mm-hmm. What started that? It wasn't them that
Heavy
made
Rain, it popular. Heavy Rain, Beyond Two Souls.
Yeah.
Those are great games, too. Mm-hmm. Once again, for people who don't like playing video games, it's a narrative experience for you.
Yeah.
The most gameplay you'd be doing in that is walking around and picking up items.
Yeah, something
like that. Supermassive. That sounds familiar. Yeah. And their symbol's like a spiral, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. But yeah, I mean, even too with those games, they do chapter wise.
Yeah.
So it's like, it's almost like a series.
Yeah.
You know, you play chapter one, you're like, I'll take a break.
Mm-hmm. Play the next chapter. Yeah.
There you go. So.
That game had some tense parts, bro.
Until Dawn.
Yeah. I got some of the images.
Yeah. That was a great game.
Coming over, we played that. So.
How was your ending? What'd you guys get?
We had
one survivor, right? Eh?
No,
didn't we kill them all.
No,
he played most of it. We just kind of
So
and go where and
the
go
first where. Time we all played it together, we took turns making decisions.
So it was just okay.
So I believe, remember the one guy who follows the flamethrower dude in that like mansion, and he puts his hand in the bear trap. So we played it where he got his fingers cut off.
Yeah, I think I got that too.
The bitch character, the one who was always mad at her boyfriend,
the Asian one,
she died.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
She
died. I got her dead too.
I thought we killed a lot. And
the blonde bimbo
it was in the cave when the thing's chasing you, like the creature, and you could have gone one way.
Like you're supposed to like hide or something.
We chose not to, but like, the game fucked it up. Like it missed. We chose one way.
There are like eight characters. I think we came out with four or five.
Together? Yeah.
Yeah, because the guy with his fingers survived. Hayden Panettiere survived. The main chick.
There were like two or three that survived.
The serial, the guy who was pulling a prank, he survived. The blonde bimbo died. Remember when they went to go have sex at the cabin?
Yes.
She died.
Yes.
Yeah.
I forgot about her.
I at one point thought, you know that part in the game where she gets snatched through the door?
Yeah.
I thought at one point
through the window or whatever?
Yeah, she was a default death.
Oh, yeah.
That's what I thought at one point. And then later you find her. Yeah. A couple people survived the game. Then I replayed the whole thing to see how everyone
different,
could live.
Yeah, trust.
Yeah,
it's great game.
And all different.
There's so many different possibilities. Yeah.
So many. It's a great game. Love. That's what I'm saying. Like, even the Heavy Rain, Beyond Two Souls. I don't know if you guys played those, but those are fantastic too. Detroit Become Human.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah, no.
Awesome.
Never played it.
Yeah, if you like Until Dawn, you'll like that. It's basically like a story of.
I was gonna play Until with my girlfriend and
let her. Yeah.
It's that's like a good... not actually a game. Like,
that's what we're saying. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, like that, if you're not into games, play this game.
Yeah.
This will get you into that, you know. Mm-hmm. But yeah, Detroit Become Human is basically about like a world of AIs, but humans use them as like butlers.
Oh.
Yeah.
Shit.
And then all of a sudden, there's an AI uprising.
And, oh shit. Yeah.
Want some cookies and caramel cookie.
Okay.
So. Oh, just do an ASMR.
Yes, listen here.
So listen here. We got a caramel cookie coffee. Yeah. And a malazzo.
All right.
So. We got to talk about this. At least in at least one podcast. What, in your opinion.
Okay.
What are the chances that the Rams make the Super Bowl this year?
Oh, boy. Next year or this year, you said?
This year.
We got a next pretty hard game next week, though.
They do.
Wow.
Because we are both Rams fans.
Yes.
We are both Rams fans.
See, if you were going to talk about this topic, I would have brought the whole gear, you know, the hat.
I had to throw you off. Socks. I had to throw you off with this one because I want to know the truth.
Are they in playoffs?
This is the divisional round they're going to. So there's only eight teams left. They're in the Elite Eight.
Yes. Honestly, like I didn't believe. I thought it was gonna be next year.
Mm-hmm.
But once I saw some trades happening,
Vaughn Miller, Odell Beckham, Matthew Stafford. Yeah, especially when you lose Robert Woods, that you can't replace Robert Woods. So getting Odell definitely helps them.
It's looking up, I will say, especially with that slaughter.
Oh my god, 34-11. That was disgusting. No, 34-11. The Cardinals only got 3 points at the end. The Cardinals only got 11 points at the end because the Rams are kind of like, just let them have it. Yeah, it's garbage time.
Just like, just fucking around.
Okay. Before the season started, I said the Rams were going to the Super Bowl. And I...
You did.
I feel like I'm beating a dead horse when I say this. Because I always say, I don't choose the Rams to go to the Super Bowl every year. Last year, didn't have them going.
I feel like, you didn't say that.
No. Last year, I had them losing the wild card. Mm-hmm. They actually made the divisional. The year before was a lost year.
Yeah.
Even the year they made the Super Bowl, at the beginning of the year, I had them losing in the conference.
Really?
And they beat the Saints. Really? They went to the Super Bowl. This year's different. This year has Super Bowl written all over it. I just feel it. I feel the Rams are going to the Super Bowl. Even in the moments where the Rams haven't looked as pretty as they maybe should.
They should be.
I still kept that in the back of my head that, like, no, they're going to turn things around, man.
Where was it they usually were?
Sorry?
St. Louis Rams,
yeah. And I mean, they mainly moved from St. Louis because sure, they had a fan base, but they weren't doing anything. They couldn't do anything, so they had to leave and go back to where they were. In LA, you get winners. Whether or not you are going to win the big game, you still get winners. You get people who are just good at the sport. Okay. So far, I'm 6-6. I predicted wild card weekend perfectly. Every winner, I predicted it.
Mm-hmm.
For the divisional, I have Rams beating the Buccaneers. I do have the Packers beating the 49ers.
So then that would leave...
Rams, Packers.
Yeah.
Then I have Chiefs beating the Bills. Even though I'm kind of doubting myself right now, I think the Bills can do it.
Over the Chiefs.
I do think they can do it.
You think it's going to be one of those where, like, they just win?
Oh, it's going to be close.
Yeah, okay.
It's going to be 24-20. Something crazy.
Just end it.
And it'll be like the last drive of the game, Josh Allen and the Bills.
Yeah.
They have 60, 70 yards to go in a minute and a half, and they can't do it. Something like that, yeah. So Chiefs over the Bills, although I will say if the Bills take it, won't be surprised. Chiefs over Bills, Bengals over Titans. So then it'll be Bengals, Chiefs, Rams, Packers. I have Rams, Bengals.
Really?
I have Rams, Bengals, Super Bowl.
Get your bets in now, yo, because I'm going to put my shit in.
My second choice is Rams, Bills.
Okay.
But
okay.
Rams, no matter what, I think they're doing it.
LA. Oh, it is LA.
It's in their home stadium. Things.
I mean, do you want to get a flight or something? Because we.
Bro, that would cost a leg and an arm. Yeah,
and I would give a leg and an arm. Here you go. Look, this year, and maybe it'll blow up in my face and all other Rams fans.
Yeah.
Okay. But the way I see it is you acquire Matthew Stafford. You get Von Miller, you get Odell Beckham. Your offense and defense, if you play the game correctly, they're going, to execute on every play of the game.
Like on paper.
It's going to happen. Yeah. Look what they did the Cardinals. Yeah. come on. I don't care if people are saying, oh, well, the Cardinals weren't the same team. I don't care, dog.
Yeah.
They were the best team in the league for over half a year. Yeah. The fact that they no a one
slapping should, still a slapping
yeah no like no that. One should be getting beat that way.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so move on from that. Even just other things I'm feeling, man. Like I'm feeling like, you know, the Super Bowl's in LA.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the halftime show
is
being played by people who are all from LA.
I feel like it's giving them a big push.
It has to.
Everyone's like, yo, like, come on.
And, like, you know? And for the first time in history, you had Tampa Bay Buccaneers play in their own home stadium last year and win the Super Bowl in their home. Why not do it again with the Rams? Wow. I'm just saying, if the league ever wanted to be rigged, if the NFL wanted to be rigged,
this is the year. How you do
it. Now, who would you rather, like, I don't want to say it, but who would you rather lose to if you were to lose?
Like Bucks or Packers?
Like the better, yeah.
So there's like Packers, three options, because if the 49ers win. So Bucks, Niners, Packers.
I keep dropping this.
How do I want to say this? Buccaneers, I would be upset. Okay?
Yeah, that's...
Green Bay.
What? Actually, really? You'd be upset by the Bucks?
I would.
Really?
The Rams have had their number over the past couple of years.
Yeah, you did mention
the Rams can beat this Buccaneers team, no question.
Yeah. Yeah.
Especially, too, the Buccaneers are injury prone right now. The Rams can do this. The only thing is
it's Tom Brady.
I get it.
Yeah.
You can't count out Tom Brady, but he's not unbeatable.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, you can beat him. Mm-hmm. You just got a game plan, game call right. So I would be upset because I know they can win this. Mm-hmm. The Packers, 50-50. I'd be okay with it, but I'd also be very mad, and I'll explain why.
Okay.
But the 49ers, I will... I would be absolutely furious because I despise that team.
Really?
Yeah.
Mahomes?
No, that's the Chiefs. Yeah. No, 49ers have Jimmy Garoppolo, which is terrible QB. But yeah, I would be infuriated if we lost to the 49ers.
See, that's the thing. I'm going to go off with that. Packers, 100%, I would understand, mm-hmm. but I'd be a little bit pissed.
Yeah.
And anybody we lose to, you're going to be pissed.
Yeah. It's going to be, yeah, of course.
Yeah, you're going to be pissed.
Yeah.
49ers, I feel like I've always, ever since even St. Louis, they're in St. Louis, I've always had this rivalry in my head with Rams and 49ers.
So if... Bitching team, like just
49ers. Yeah. They are, yeah. bro.
Like you see all their players, like, I just want to fucking play.
Yeah, like, yeah. It's no surprise that the 49ers are a pretty hated fan base.
Yeah.
They kind of are. I'd say that the most hated fan bases are the Patriots and the Cowboys.
Yeah.
People hate the Cowboys, bro.
Not really the Patriots anymore, though, you think?
I still think so.
Yeah?
Because I still think these are the same people who are saying, just watch, it's going to be a Mac Jones, Tom Brady Super Bowl. Yeah? Did you guys see the score of the Buffalo game? It was 47-17. So I don't know how that worked out for you. And I just think people really... I'll say this. They don't know what it's like to lose.
Yeah,
the Patriots.
They don't.
So when they're sitting here crying about losing a playoff game, shut the fuck up.
Yeah.
There are fan base. Look at the Cardinals. The Cardinals haven't won a Super Bowl since 1946. And it wasn't even called Super Bowl yet. It was called NFL Championship.
I didn't know that.
And the Patriots are going to sit here and be like, we're not going anywhere anymore. What do you mean?
Yeah.
You have six Super Bowls.
Yeah. In a span of a short ass time.
You had a dynasty.
Yeah.
So shut the hell up.
Yeah, it's done.
Yeah.
You're right.
You know, and I can see the Patriots in the next couple of years coming back.
Yeah.
I can see it. So don't be sitting here crying mm-hmm. that your team lost and that your team is garbage. You don't know what garbage is.
Yeah.
So where were we
before
the Packers, hated fan bases. Yeah. So the Packers.
Yeah.
I wouldn't. Here's a piece of why I wouldn't hate it. I wouldn't hate it because the way I see it is, the Packers are a good team, dude.
They're a fucking great team.
They're a fucking great team.
You got to be honest with that one.
They're, you know, it's crazy how that defense is mediocre, but they find a way to be great.
Yo, I feel like it's the morale. I would love to be just on the bench, just on that team.
Or a fly on the wall.
Yeah.
Just like, what are they talking about?
Yeah, what's going on, dude?
How do they play so good
yeah.
when they're not good? Like... Like, they don't have a fantastic defense, but for some reason they rally and play like a great defense.
You ever think Rodgers just get fucking pissed at the defense?
Like, they just play the fucking game.
Yeah, just, yo, I'm doing all this fucking work.
He probably threatens, I will leave. If you guys don't play, I will leave.
I'm gone. Listen here.
It's a play. And they're like, okay. Okay, sir. Yeah. So I wouldn't be mad because they're a great team. And I do respect the Packers. Mm-hmm. Why I would be mad is this. The Rams make the NFC Championship against the Packers. And the Rams lose to the Packers in the NFC Championship. The reason that makes me mad is because Green Bay has lost the NFC Championship like 6 times. And then we're the one to give them a victory. That's why I would be mad. Because there's already a pattern of the Packers already losing that game so often.
It's true.
Yeah. And then we give them the win. Then,
yeah, that's how they get the dub.
Like Toronto Maple Leafs or something.
And then they get to play in our stadium? No. No. And think about this too. SoFi Stadium is the most expensive stadium in the world. It's brand new and it's shaped like a ram head. And you don't want the Rams going to that Super Bowl? Please, NFL, if it's rigged, rig it.
Yeah.
Rig this, it, bro. This is how you fucking do it. Just if this is rigged, be honest and just say the Rams were always meant to go to the Super Bowl this year. Like, but in all honesty, like, not joking, I do think they can do it.
Yeah.
I do think they can do this.
Are they taking it in the championship, you think? In the Super Bowl?
Like, are they winning it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, no question.
No hands down?
Sean McVay's not going to another Super Bowl and losing. And he's not going to another Super Bowl and only dropping 3 points.
Yeah, that was kind of embarrassing.
And obviously, Goff was a huge issue. Goff was definitely a huge issue.
But, like, he had so much potential. I want to talk about this because I definitely watched him. And I saw, yo, first round pick. Yo, this is my guy. Rams are going to be looking nice.
Checking all the boxes.
What the fuck happened? Mm-hmm. I was like, yo, what?
So, first of all, year number one for Jared Goff, not his fault.
Yeah.
Not his fault.
Yeah.
They had a 4-12 team. Course, yeah. He was a rookie. The coaching staff was terrible. He had no one to throw to. True, yeah. No offense. No offense.
Yeah.
Second year, you get Sean McVay, one of the most brilliant minds out there in the NFL, and he's 35.
Yeah.
He's 35 years old. He's a head coach. Mm. That changed him because Sean McVay worked with quarterbacks. Sean McVay knows what makes a great quarterback. Look at what they did. They were doing consistent 4-12 seasons, 6-10 seasons, and he transferred them to 11-5. They won the division, went to the playoffs. Yeah, they're inexperienced. They lost. It's gonna happen. That's what's gonna happen. Yeah. Year later, go to the Super Bowl.
That's crazy though.
Jared Goff played like an MVP. He was an MVP that year. I'm not saying he should have won it.
The year they went to
the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
He was an MVP that year. He played unbelievable. Unbelievable. The second half of the season comes out, and my guy's throwing bricks. My guy's like, you're on the 20-yard line? I'll throw it on the 30.
I gotta say.
Yeah. Yeah.
I hate that word now.
Bricks?
Bricks.
Why?
Just because, like...
Wrong.
I just hear bricked up so much. Hear that so much.
Is that like a black people movie?
I guess so, yeah. It's like, yo, I'm bricked up, man. What I
what does it mean?
I just like you're hard.
You're bricked up.
Like you're bricked up.
You're
bricked up.
I thought you were like
you're
so bricked,
you're like, oh, I'm bricked up.
So
whenever I hear just throwing bricks.
Oh, gosh. Jared Goff was bricked up,
he was bricked up that game.
I gotta get the ball down there. Anyways,
yeah,
holy. He was throwing duds. Yeah, let's say that. Thank you. I'll give you that one. Yeah, that. You're welcome. He wasn't playing the same.
Yeah. What do you think changed?
There could be a lot of things, pressure, stress, the limelight even, like there could be a lot of things. There
was a big spotlight on him at that time.
Yes.
A lot of people talking about
it. When you are a first round pick and you are not executing, there's discussion. So he has the best year of his career. And honestly, that year, Jared Goff was potentially shaping up to be one of the best quarterbacks in the future. Mm. All of a sudden, they lose the Super Bowl. They have a sophomore slump. Obviously, when you go to the Super Bowl, you are not meant to come out better. Yeah. The Super Bowl is meant to destroy you. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, that's what's going to happen. How often do teams leave a Super Bowl losing, by the way, and are destroyed the year after?
It's true.
Other than the Patriots. Because Bill Belichick and Tom Brady found ways to always do good the year after. Yeah. So they have their sophomore slump. They come back the next year because you obviously know Sean McVay, whether or not it's going to happen, he wants a dynasty in LA. Sean McVay wants to be the new Patriots. That is what he wants. Mm-hmm. Whether or not it will happen, it is what he wants.
Yeah.
Jared Goff was not going to do that for them. Bro, my guy was addicted to dump passing. Just no one's open.
Yeah.
Here's the running back.
Yeah.
That's all he would do.
That's true.
He couldn't sense pressure. He got sacked 24/7. He had the most turnovers in 2 years. He just constantly fumbled the ball.
Yeah.
So you need to make a change.
Yeah.
And the change started with a quarterback. So you get probably the most underrated and disrespected quarterback in NFL history, Matthew Stafford. People want to talk shit about him all day. Just look at his stats. It proves how good he is.
Yeah. And he's doing his thing.
He's doing his thing.
He's doing his thing. One basketball player. What's his name? Andrew Wiggins.
Oh, yeah. The Canadian guy.
Got all aligned. Yeah. Like, not saying he's shit in the bed, but they hyped him up to be the next LeBron James, the next star. He's just coasting.
Hype can kill.
Hype can kill.
His college ball was like nuts.
Yeah.
Like,
look at Baker Mayfield right now.
Ah, okay. Yeah.
What's he doing now, dude? I know he's injured. I know he's got some issues.
But still.
I literally just got an update 10 minutes ago saying he's out for 6 months.
Oh, damn.
So he might not even start next season, like, right away.
Yeah.
But still. Yeah. But still. Why do you think OBJ left? Do you know how many touchdowns OBJ had in his career? And
Over there? Yeah. I heard it was low. What was
three.
It? Like three. Yeah. That's fucked.
He had three touchdowns as a Brown. He has seven as a Ram, six as a Ram right now, and he's played 7-8 games.
That's crazy.
Come on, bro. He's never had a playoff touchdown. He got one the other night because Stafford knows how to get the ball to these guys. Mm-hmm. And bro, Odell's hands.
Oh, they're sticky.
They're huge.
They're sticky.
Because he's bricked up,
he's bricked up.
I'm bricked up and I'm
He's bricked up. He's catching them.
Stafford's
balls.
Like, how did you catch that? I'm bricked up.
Imagine that huddle. That huddle's crazy.
Bring it in. Bring it
What?
Yeah, I'm bricked up, dog.
All right, sick. Next play.
Yeah, all my on his sticky hands. Sick, bro. He's not dropping that.
Yeah.
Why do you think he made that spectacular one-hander a couple years ago? Like, you know, come on, bro.
Yeah. Damn.
So percentage-wise, what do you think the chances of them going?
Ooh. Going or, like, winning?
Both.
Going, I gotta say, it's high. It's a high chance, especially with all... But when you're talking about the hype kills, especially with all of like the factors of like it's a home game, like there's a lot of stuff gunning for them. I'm gonna say like 70% of them going.
I think as a fan of football and a fan of the Rams and just general respect for other teams, I think you do have to have. I think it needs to be 70% because 70% of you is believing in your team, but the other 30% of you is respecting everyone else.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, if they make the Super Bowl, if that 70% chance is true, I'm saying 90% they're winning.
They're winning.
Yeah. Once again, I can't see Sean McVay and that team walking in and saying, if we get 3 points, we're going to win. It's not going to happen. It's not going to happen.
All we need is a field goal, boy.
I know. Could you imagine? The final score is 3-2. Rams win. There was a safety. Rams win 3. Could you imagine 3-2?
That'd be crazy.
Sean McVay would want to go in there and be like, I want 35 points because I want first half, because I want everyone to forget about our 3-point outing a couple years ago.
That's true, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm with you. If they go in, they're winning it. I got to say that. They're winning.
Yeah.
It would be crazy to experience that game, though. Fuck. Take out the TFSA. Don't worry.
I wanted to go to a game this year so badly anyways because I wanted to experience that stadium.
Yeah.
If I can kind of sneak into that Super Bowl, I'm definitely going to LA. Yeah,
tickets are probably like, what, like 2K now? God.
Well,
way more than that.
Yeah? I mean, the chances of like getting into the Super Bowl right now.
Cheapest Super Bowl ticket I saw one time was like
$8,500. Because
that's like nosebleed nowhere.
That's the thing about the Super Bowl. You're not a fan of the teams. You're just going to go because it's an experience.
Especially if you're in LA too.
You get the shows, you get like
halftime, right? Everything.
I gotta say that compared to like our fucking CFL, I was looking at tickets. I was like, yo, $600? Fuck, that's expensive.
Like, you know, $1,600 for the Super Bowl.
The Patriots are going for like their big whatever. I think tickets are going for like
$25,000. Damn. See, but I'd probably go, to be honest.
Yeah, like, it's an experience.
Not $25,000. That's
no, but I know what you mean.
But like, if I knew I was already going to be in that city at that time, I'd be like, okay, like, how can I get these tickets for cheap on time? Like, you know?
Now, if I had a net worth of 7 figures, okay, I'll drop $25,000 for, you know, fine, whatever. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So, I think... I really think it's going to happen. I really do.
That'd be crazy.
I look at this team and I think about how many people want it. Mm-hmm. You know, Matthew Stafford wants a Super Bowl, bro.
Yeah.
Odell Beckham, obviously.
Yeah, he fucking, yeah.
Andrew Whitworth, the left tackle. My guy's 40 years old. He wants a Super Bowl, bro. Mm.
Donald wants a fucking...
Aaron Donald deserves it.
He deserves it, though. Yeah.
I can't imagine a Rams team with a defense of Aaron Donald, Jalen Ramsey, and Von Miller losing a Super Bowl. I just can't, can't fathom something like that happening. And look, if it happens, it happens. Mm-hmm. Like, what are you going to do, right? Yeah. I'm not a player. You can't control what happens on the field.
Yeah.
But I can't see it. Mm-hmm. I just can't see them losing.
Damn. That'd be a game. That's going to be a game.
I think the Rams are heavily being doubted.
Yeah.
Because of how they've kind of played through the regular season. Mm-hmm. As if going 12 wins and 5 losses is a bad thing.
Yeah.
Come on, man. They didn't go 5-12. Mm-hmm. They went 12-5 and won their division.
Do you think like winning like say the NFC or something is like a big thing? Like, you think they win that and they're just like, "Yay."
Like, you know, like, they don't want that.
Obviously, yeah. You're like, gunning for the Super Bowl, no matter what.
We're going for
NFC, AFC championship games. Yeah. It's a big deal. You even get a trophy for it.
It's like NHL, you get your...
Yeah.
Commissioner hands it to you. You're like...
It almost feels like a participation award. Like, you know?
Yeah, in the NHL, none of them touch the trophy.
Really,
considered bad luck.
No way.
Touch the trophy, you're not going to win Stanley Cup.
Really?
I didn't know that.
It's like saying, like, oh... You wanted that one, so pick up that one. Why would you want the other? So no one
has that been proven too. Like, have teams done that?
I don't know. I've never actually looked at the stats, but no team, if you see that win their championship,
they don't touch it.
They will go and they'll all stand next to it. You'll see them kind of make sure their arm doesn't touch it and all smile, and then they'll go on.
That's crazy.
They're not there for that.
Wow. Okay. Yeah. That's interesting. I mean, it's exciting, of course.
Yeah.
Because you won your side of the sport.
And
you know,
face the big boy or the other
you beat the other 15 teams. Like, you're the best of 15 on your side. But now, exactly like you said, you got to play the big game.
Do you think that that's like a night of drinking? Or is it kind of like, yay, we
have
won.
Have a cigar.
True. Like, you're kind of sitting back. Like, but it's not like, yeah.
No.
No, it's not one of those.
That's like the interview with Kobe Bryant. He's like up two.
Yeah, two of them.
You guys like, why are you? He's like, Job's not done.
It's true. And that's what makes it even more desperate for football, mm-hmm. is it's survival, yo. Yeah.
That's not their playoffs.
Like, you don't, you're done. Yeah. You need to show up every game of the year. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to say this right now. Sean McVay, okay? He is known to go on a tear when he loses games. When he loses, his win-loss record I saw recently is when he loses a game, he's like 21-4.
Damn.
So, bro, when he wins, he...
Win, loss, win.
So it's probably a good idea that he maybe lost the last game of the season, because now he's like, I'm going to kill everyone. And once again, I'll just say, if the other teams out here have more of a killer instinct than the Rams, you deserve to win the Super Bowl.
That's true. But they shouldn't.
The Rams, this is their year. So I think Rams Super Bowl 56 champions. I'm going to say it. I've been saying it all year. I can't.
I like that certified stamp.
Yeah. Bob. Yeah. Bricked up.